soon as when he returned back from his classes, he had to take bath, have breakfast, and then he go to school. In afternoon, when he would return from school, then he go to take many classes such as maths tuition and swimming classes. He also used to take guitar lessons on alternate days. He loved playing with his friends, watching television, and playing games on the computer. And most importantly, he also had to do his homework. It is very difficult to do so many things for a child who is studying only in the 6th standard. There were days when he could not get time to do his homework. His teachers would scold him. Sometimes he could not complete the work given in tuition. Then his mother and his tuition teachers would scold him. It is used to happen many times that he could not get time even to do his homework. Because of this, he was also scolding from his teachers. When he did not do his tuition work also, he would get scolded by both his mother and his tuition teachers also. One day he was so tired that his body refused to move when he woke up in the morning. He went off to sleep again. When he got up, it was already past his school time. He had to miss the school and his mother scolded him. One day he was so tired that when he woke up, his body was refusing to move. So he fell asleep again. When he wakes up, he is too late for the school. He missed his school time. He missed his school. He missed his bus also. Then he scolded by his mother as he missed his school. Dinesh felt really sad because he did not do it intentionally. He just felt too tired to get up that day. In the evening, his grandmother came to visit them. Dinesh was very fond of his granny. He asked her, "Nani, can you help me? I want to do so many things, but I do not have enough time to do them." Dinesh felt very bad when he got scolded because he did not do it intentionally. He was very tired, so he could not get up that day. His grandmother was coming to meet them that evening. Dinesh loved his grandmother very much. He asked for help from his grandmother. He asked that, "Grandmother, can you please help me?" He told his grandmother his problem, that he want to do a lot of things, but he does not have enough time to do them. Grandmother sat with him and asked him to make a list of all the things that he had to do. They divided the list into 3 parts. The first part had things which he had to do every day. The second part had those things which he had to do during weekend, and the third part had those things which he liked to do when he got bored. Dinesh listed all these jobs under these 3 parts. Now, grandmother listened to Dinesh and then asked him to make a list of all the things that he wants to do. After making the list, they divided it into 3 parts. In the first part, they kept those things which he had to do daily. In the second part, they kept those things which he had to do on the weekend. And in the third part, they kept those things which he liked to do when he feel bored. Now he divided all his work into these three parts: homework, getting things ready for school, tennis and swimming practice, tuition, polishing shoes, and doing some household jobs. Went to into the first part. Now doing homework, getting ready for school, practicing tennis and swimming, going for tuition, polishing his shoes, and other household chores came into the first part. All these things came into the first part. Reading storybooks, playing with friends, tidying, repeat this word, tidying means cleaning bookshelves, watching television and doing extra studies went into the second part. Now, reading books, playing with friends, cleaning bookshelves, watching television, studying extra means giving extra time to the study. All these things came into the second part. Painting, playing video games, going for movies and picnics went into the third part. Now, into the third part, he included painting, playing video games, going for movies and picnics. All these things he put into the third part. Grandmother said to Dinesh, "Now that you know your priorities," priorities means the thing that are important, "you can make your timetable accordingly. Make two timetables, one for the school days and one for the weekends. Then follow them well. Also make sure that you do not put too many activities in them, otherwise you may not be able to follow them."